It's a very great day for me to see so many Sahayogis here who are from this country, Greece. When first I came to Greece, I told my husband that this country is full of vibrations and there have been many evolved souls in this country. But perhaps the people have lost their heritage, but the vibrations are in the atmosphere. And one day Sahaja Yoga should prosper here very much. And somehow we met some bureaucrats who were Greeks and the experience was not good with them. And my husband said that if you said that Greeks are really religious people, then look at these people, what are they doing to me? I said they may be bureaucrats, and all over bureaucrats you can't say what sort of people they could be. But on the whole, the vibrations were very, very good, no doubt. And I went to all the places in here, like I went to Delphi, I went up there to see Athena's temple and everything, to all the places of interest. They took me down, especially me, because he was busy with his conference, and so they took me down. And everywhere I felt, even the sea I felt was so beautiful. This was about, I think I came here at least about 15 years back, maybe 14 years back. And I find now, the vibrations are coming back now through you people, and the whole place is again vibrating. Now you have to understand that you people have a very big responsibility, because you are strategically placed in Greece, you see. Greece and Italy, I mean Turkey, both are very important. First of all, you are the bridge between the eastern side and the western side. And everybody is interested in somehow or other managing these two areas so that they could control eastern and western side. I mean the western country especially. Now the greatest danger that you have now is that this western culture may try to grab you, and which is very dangerous. To understand it, you have to know that you are people coming from a very great tradition, ancient people of ages just like Indians. And there is so much you can do to improve the culture of Europe by your own behavior. Like these people who are coming here, tourists are coming. And they see the behavior of the Greeks. And they see that they can influence very well the Europeans, think that Greeks can be very easily influenced by their culture, by their cheap life. So, as you being the such traditional people, down to earth, and so many good things you have known in life, it's very important to understand the historical background of your country, first of all. For Sahaja Yogis, it is very important to be educated that way. Because tomorrow you will have to talk to other people and you will have to tell them about Athena, about your traditions, about your background and how it is connected to Sahaja Yoga, connected to Mother Mary, connected to Christ and all those. For this it is very necessary that we all should try to understand the historical background of this country and educate yourself in a way that you can talk about Sahaja Yoga. As it is, you know, Athena has the Kundalini in her hand, and you can see that clearly that she was the Adi Shakti. Actually, in Sanskrit language, Atha means primordial. So she was the primordial mother. because there was no connection left between the Greeks and the Indians, this translation was not there, and they didn't know what it meant by Athena. But Indians know that this is the place for the manifestation of the Adi Shakti. Because in the Devi Mahatmya, if you read, you will find out they have described Greece as the Manipur Dweep, meaning the island in the Manipur. Manipur is this Nabhi Chakra. So in the Nabhi, there's an island which is Greece, where the goddess resides, Manipur Chakreshi, she resides. And so this Athena has been described, and when I went to her temple, I found that there was a little temple for the child god, that was Sri Ganesha. And then when I went to Delphi also, when I went there, I was surprised to see they showed me a mound, said this is the Nabhi, navel of the whole universe. I said, that's correct. But when I turned around, there were lots of vibrations, and what I find is a Ganesha statue there. Then Gregor came here, he took photographs and everything, and he saw that. So now you are the Nabhi, you are sitting here in the Nabhi of the whole universe. So how important is Nabhi? You know that very well. That Nabhi Chakra gets spoiled, the whole life becomes miserable for a human being. So on the right side of the Nabhi, as you see, is the liver. And because, of course, we had lots of philosophers, they used to think a lot, and they created lots of tragedies. You see, Greek tragedies, well known, where a marriage system was a little bit challenged, that there was, say, two men, one woman, or maybe two women, one man, and never they felt happy with the marriage. So the left Nabhi was under attack throughout. To have such a tragedy, they wrote so many, dramas, and they played them here, so many plays were there, showing that there are two men and one woman, or two women and one man. And no relationship between the husband and wife, it was pure. And that was the tragedy. It's known all over as the Greek tragedy. It's all imaginary. And people, you see, became very left-sided to begin with. They started thinking, oh, this life is a misery, it's a tragedy, what should we do, why should we try to show that we are happy, we are very unhappy people, and all these things started here, to begin with. Then came these, your Orthodox Church. Now this Orthodox Church is another one, which of course is really doesn't treat women very well and treats them as if they are all the time unholy. Certain times they cannot go to church and they cannot touch people, all kinds of nonsensical ideas they had. That also made women very left-sided. Then on top of that, all this was happening with these tragedies and all that. Suddenly the economic problem came up, and people felt very sort of disgusted about that. So the left side became very, very prominent here, and that is how I think many of these left-sided Buddhist organizations started. And many gurus came who made you feel miserable. But the worst that was done by the Greek Church, which made you feel so guilty. So you became very left-sided. Now this left-sidedness was later on counterbalanced by people who started becoming overactive, thinking too much, working too hard, and all those things. But still I think that they don't work very hard as they should work. They are on the lazy side, the Greeks are. They are on the lazy side. Of course the Sahayogis are not. Sahayogis have worked very hard, I can see all that very clearly. But otherwise. So, now to bring out Sahaja Yoga in Greece is important, first of all, to know what is our historical background. The secondly, we should be very well equipped with the knowledge of chakras and centers and how to improve these centers. This, if you do not have that knowledge, you cannot face people. It's not that only men should know, women also should know everything about it. What is the chakras are, how they work out, and what are their results are, how do we suffer because our chakras are in danger. All this knowledge is free to you. You don't have to pay for this knowledge. Only thing, every day-to-day life when you start working out Sahaja Yoga, then you'll find that what I'm saying is absolutely tangible. You can verify it. It is so. It's not something in the air. It is absolutely there. We can prove everything that we believe in. And we can show others also that this is the truth. It's an absolute truth. We are not here to spread some sort of a fanaticism or racialism or anything like that. But we are here to combine the whole world together under one understanding that we belong to one universe and we have one universal religion. Now people will ask you, then have you to give up your religion? You don't have to tell them that you have to give up your religion. Don't have to say that. You don't have to be hard with them at all. On the contrary, no. Nothing has to be done. You just come and take to Sahaja Yoga and take to your spirit. Gradually it will start opening up. It has happened with all of you that first when you came to Sahaja Yoga, you were in a different shape. Now gradually it started opening out, you matured and you understood Sahaja Yoga very well. In the same way, we must teach others in the same manner, with the same understanding, compassion and love. Otherwise normally people think that somebody is to be condemned all the time. Of course some are people who are under bad influence and you cannot get along with them. But most of you should know that we have to get more people into Sahaja Yoga through our compassion, love and also lot of understanding about others' feelings. I found that even countries where have been Sahaja Yoga for so many times, suddenly someone comes up and starts giving trouble and becoming bhutish sort of thing. See, and misbehaving. Suddenly it happens. Such a person, we know, if it is informed, we can take him out of Sahaja Yoga, we can cleanse him. But all of you must know one thing for definite, that you all have these powers. To cure yourself, improve yourself, to help others, you can do everything yourself. You all have these powers. But the only thing is you have to be sincere and honest. If you are not sincere and honest, it will never work out. On the contrary, it will boomerang on you. So in Sahaja Yoga, it's very important is the sincerity of purpose. You must have complete sincerity of purpose that you are here to achieve your own self-emancipation first. And secondly, you are here to help others. The people all along in the whole world now require help. There's so many problems, so many catastrophes, so many horrible things we every day know going on. So now we need people who are solid, who are balanced, who are peaceful, who understand what is right and what is wrong. But apart from that, you should know that you have now entered into the kingdom of God. Many people will say, all right, we were so religious, we were praying to Christ, we were praying to this one, praying to that one. What did we get? You cannot get it because you are not connected. You have to be connected. Once you are connected to that, then you will find that things start sorting out. But sincerity is very important and faith in yourself. You must have faith in yourself that you are quite capable person, and you can achieve a very high degree of awareness by which you can work out many things. It doesn't matter from what sort of background you come in, it doesn't matter what sort of country you come in, race, anything. You all can do very well, and we have seen this happening in so many countries where we had no hope at all. For example, a country like Russia. Imagine, they never worshipped any god. They didn't know about God. They were not allowed to know about any religion, anything. But suddenly I went there, I don't know, they recognized me, suddenly. They just recognized me, and just with my photograph I find them there. I was amazed that the first time I went to Leningrad, there were 2,000 seats in the hall. But outside they were all standing. I said, why are they standing outside? They said, all the seats are full, mother, and these are extra people. There are more than 2,000 outside. So I said, this is too much. And so they said, mother, what about us? I said, all right, let me finish the program. Went inside, did the program, everything happened. And you'll be amazed, when we had the program, the people who were outside were still waiting. I gave realization to people, and they were waiting, waiting, waiting. When I came out, I gave them, I said, now what to do? I can't give you realization just now. So they said, all right, what can we do? I said, tomorrow morning can you come? They said, all right. So all those who were inside and those who were outside, all of them came and sat down in that open ground, and I gave them realization. So this is the first beginning, but now in Moscow or any place, we have to reserve a huge big stadium. 14,000 to 16,000 people are there, and realization is being given. But they are so quick to accept Sahajyoga, so quick to accept me, too quick to understand Sahajyoga. I just can't imagine how these Russians have got this capacity. No question of their going back, no question of their sincerity being challenged, there is no question of their doubting themselves, nothing. Just there, and so much so, so much, that I sometimes feel this democracy has just harmed us. Because of democracy, of course, we could do Sahajyoga all right. But where the people are absolutely sometimes very idiotic. Like in America, I find there's very idiotic people live there, and they were only busy choosing their bathrooms and their curtains and their soaps, and all the time they were choosing only the busy with all these nonsensical things. They are so idiotic, while the people in Russia are so sensible, so deep, so introspective, and even the artists and the scientists. I had a conference with the scientists, there were about 300 of them, and I started talking to them about science. I thought, better start with science. They said, mother, no more science, no more science. Tell us the science of God. Such open-minded people. We have 200 doctors in Russia who are practicing Sahajyoga, and it has spread up to Siberia. Now, what's the use of this democracy which doesn't take us to God? It doesn't give us sense that we should seek God and we should be humble towards God. So what's the use of having this kind of a democracy and this kind of freedom which has made us mad and idiotic? And that's very true about every democratic country, because you must know democracy is money-oriented. And you know Greeks are very money-oriented people also as well. Of course they are not as bad as Americans, but they are quite money-oriented. Also Italians are very money-oriented, but the worst is the corruption. Now Italy is getting exposed, I'm sure your country will also get exposed, all these countries are to be exposed. But first of all, the Sahajyogis have to be firm people. They have to be very, very firm. And they should know that Sahajyoga is only spirit-oriented, nothing but spirit-oriented. That you have to have your spirit enlightened, that your spirit has to work everything, that you are not this body, this money, this position, these powers, nothing, but you are the spirit. This is what one has to know. I was told it is very difficult for you to come for pujas to Kabela, and you all cannot join. But 1 week, supposing you take during Guru Puja, I think, you can come by boat or something like that. Would be easier for you to come to Genoa by boat, and then we can organize your coming down. For Guru Puja, you all should come. See, Sahasrar Puja and Guru Puja are very important. And if you could come for Guru Puja, it would be a very nice idea. I think it can be arranged and organized that you can come to Guru Puja. I know it's best of I am. Supposing if I have it here, then for all the rest of the people it will be far away. So I just thought of Milan being quite in the center, that it would be nearer to England, nearer to other European countries. But still the Americans and the South Americans find it very difficult. So this time we had to provide all tickets, everything to South Americans to come. But they are very deep people. I was surprised in Colombia. Such good sahajogis, very beautiful sahajogis, very simple-hearted, very good, well-educated. 3-4 of them were got married in India and they are very happy. It's all right, forget it, it's all right. So, now for that, two things have to be done. Firstly, is that you should come to collect. It's very important you all should come to collective and please put attention to me, not to them, all right? Please put your attention towards me. Don't turn your attention very much. You have to keep your attention all right. It's very important. So, one thing is to do is to come to the collective and watch out for your attention. Where is your attention? Where are you looking? Are you turning your head too much? Or are you putting your attention straight? It's very important that you must keep your attention absolutely rapt and towards the meetings that you have here for your collective. In that way, when your attention is fixed, you'll find you will definitely rise into thoughtless awareness, a state where you grow spiritually. You have to rise up to that state of thoughtless awareness where you grow spiritually. If you are not in thoughtless awareness, you cannot grow in your spirituality. So it's very important to see where is your attention. Where are you putting your attention? If the attention could be controlled, then things will be all right. She's crying, the child is crying too much, I think. We can send it out a little bit. It's feeling hot, I think. It's all right now with the mother. So the first thing is to be in the collective. Now, it's a very sinister idea of some people is to always break the collective, to create problems, to disregard the leaders. As a result, leaders also get so fed up, they give up, you see. They don't want to have anything to do. So, they put up their own ideas, they try to trouble the leaders, they create problems for them, they just try to show off everywhere as if they know everything. All such people also create groups. So beware about that. You should stick on always to the collective and not to anyone who tries to create a kind of a group or who troubles or who makes things difficult. You must understand those who are collective only will grow, those who are will not grow. Because like a nail, if it breaks, then it doesn't grow. In the same manner, if you keep out of this thing by any chance, if you have any problems with the leaders, you can always write to me, you can tell me, I can work it out. But all the time to go on like this and grouping like this, you will break. And there will be someone who will do that. There will be some negative person who will try to do that. So you have to be very careful not to get out of the collective. Must always support the collective, must help this collective, and must nourish it. As you know, I was telling him also that if he has problem with money, we can give money from Kabela. Because before that I used to travel on my own, even to Greece I came on my own and paid for everything. So she also, then Samati said to pay something which I didn't like very much. I was paying so much because we had such a small group. But now, as you have a big group, you feel responsible, you want to pay for it, all right, doesn't matter. But not to pay for your Sahayoga, not for your realization, not for a knowledge of Sahayoga. This is there. And so people will start putting ideas into your heads that why this, why that, and all that. Such people you should keep out. Because you are here to develop your spirituality and not to listen to the stupid people who have been troublesome. So best is to keep to your own development and own nourishment. It's very important. So it is in a way collective but also individual. Because what you are gaining out of the collective, you should be on the watch out. You should see for yourself what you are gaining out of the collective. Then secondly, at home, you must every day, again I say, not to miss it out, in the evening before sleeping, you must have meditation. You can wash yourself up like the, what you call the water treatment or anything, then sit down for meditation for 10 minutes. You must give 15 minutes to yourself and then sleep off. Supposing you can't do one night, doesn't matter, but try to do it every night. If not possible, if you don't do it one night, you can do it in the morning. But it's very important. I can easily make out a person who does meditation and who does not do meditation. It's a difference. It's a difference. You can immediately know a person who is meditating every day, in his health, in his face, in his behavior, in everything, is very different. And those who do not do any meditation, you will find not only that they are funny, but their children are funny, their relationships are funny, everything is funny. So the meditation is a very important part for you. Because also the women who are pregnant, if they do not meditate, their children turn out to be very troublesome and very funny. It's a thing like that. It affects everything. But your character of meditativeness, your character of Sahaja Yoga helps everyone, your children, your family, your society, everybody. And everybody can make it out what sort of a family you are, what sort of a people you are, what sort of a personality you are. And from you they take to Sahaja Yoga. So it's important in individual life also just to meditate, nothing. You have to come to a state of thoughtless awareness. So the mantra is, as you know, Nirvichara. You should use the mantra of Nirvichara for coming to the state of thoughtlessness and try to increase this area, this space of thoughtless awareness. And that is how you will find you will be growing very well. Now as you get lots of powers, as you get lots of people being realized by you, curing by you, sometimes maybe it might affect your ego. You might get into ego things. For such people, I have to say that you have to be introspective and see for yourself. You face the mirror and ask, now how much ego you have, laugh at yourself. Once you start laughing at yourself, your ego will drop out and you will understand that it was false to have this kind of ego within you. There are so many ways and methods of finding out about yourself. Put yourself into bandhan and put your hands towards the photograph. Immediately you can feel what chakras are catching and you know how to clear it out. Also sometimes you feel it inside. If your chakras are catching, you can feel it inside and you can feel it, the different centers on your fingertips about yourself. So it is about yourself, you will know. About others, you know, you should just talk on chakras. You should not say he's bhutish or he has ego, nothing. Or you should say his agya is catching, means he has got ego. You can say his nabhi is bad. This thing is bad. So the language is to change now. We have to talk in the language of Sahaja Yoga. It is to be understood that now we are Sahaja Yogis. We've got the powers. We have vibratory powers. But if we don't use these vibratory powers, what is going to happen? We have to use them. That's the point. We always forget. I've seen the other day they couldn't open something. I said, give a bandhan. Gave a bandhan and immediately it worked out, you see. Small, small things also you'll be surprised that if it doesn't work out, you have to just give a bandhan and it works out. It is important to know that you are Sahaja Yogis, you are saints, and that you can do lots of things and you shouldn't forget it. You shouldn't forget it that you are Sahaja Yogis. Now you are no more ordinary people, you are saints now and you can do a lot. All this when it works out, You'll be amazed at yourself, how you have achieved all these things. And I tell you, people tell me that they look like roses, all of their faces shining, they look so beautiful, and they can make it out that you are such a yogis. I've seen at the airport also many people say that, who were those children, people looking so sweet and beautiful, shining, who were those? So if I tell them that they are saints, they won't believe that there could be so many saints, but there are. And we have achieved that all over the world. All over the world now there are so many sadhugis that I can't even say how many there are, in thousands and thousands. So I again tell you that Greece is a place where you can do a lot. First of all, you must establish yourself in sadhuga, and you have to know what you are all the time, to remember what you are. You are a sadhuga. Even to children you have to say you are a sadhugi. So they also develop that personality by which they behave properly, and they behave in a manner that a sadhugi should behave. So all these things are just the preliminaries of sadhuga, but I'm sure you must be getting my tapes from Kabela, and you must be knowing about all the deeper things about yourself and about sadhuga. It's a new age that has started. The other day I said that the Satya Yuga has started now. So it will start exposing all that is asatya, which whatever is false. All those are false, people will be exposed, and you'll be amazed at the way things will work out. And it's such a great time you are born, and it's such a great thing that you have come to Sahaja Yoga, and that you have got your realization, and that you are one of those who have to lift the whole of this universe into a higher awareness. Of course, we can't say how many will be saved. It's another point, because what I know about is that in the evolutionary portion, supposing we came from chimpanzees, many were lost in between, you know. And there are so many chimpanzees now left, and there's the in middle, the people were lost in the same way. Many human beings may be lost because of their stupidity, because of their self-destructive habits that they have formed. But your responsibility is very great. Don't think I'm just mediocre, I'm good for nothing. Never, never think like that. You are all saints, and you are capable of great things. May God bless you. So today they want to do the puja of Athena, and you'll be surprised that the names of Athena are exactly about the same as that of the goddess of Adi Shakti. It's very surprising. They have such beautiful names. But we can have 108 names of today, and you can read the names and the meanings, and they can say the mantras. But first the children have to wash my feet with Ganesha's Stuti, you can say. Ganesha's Stuti.